Whole Foods. I'm sure you've all heard of them. Honestly, they're my go-to whenever I need pre-peeled oranges or I'm really craving some asparagus water. Today, the story is going to be about how they managed to grow from a single store into a giant chain that revolutionized the food industry and how we eat today. So let's get to it. So Whole Foods was founded by a guy named John Mackey. He's really a fun guy. As a kid, he had a well-balanced diet of Cocoa Puffs, Pop-Tarts, and fried chicken. Honestly, for the time, that may not have been too unhealthy of a diet. Mackey says he had his food awakening at 23 when he moved to a vegetarian co-op called the Piranha House. There, he became the food buyer for the co-op and also got a job at a nearby health food store called the Good Food Company. There is where he found his passion. He enjoyed working there so much that he decided that's what he wanted to do with his life. He wanted to open his own natural food store, and that's what he did. He got a $10,000 loan from his father and managed to raise $35,000 more from friends and family, and together used that to open his first store called Saferway. Yeah, like more safe than Safeway. The store didn't even sell meat or sugar. In the first year, due to mismanagements in inventory and labor, Mackey managed to lose $23,000. He made some improvements in the second year though, and squeaked out $5,000 profit. After 2 years of hard work and losing $18,000, he decided something had to change. He decided the store had to be more like a real grocery store. He ended up merging with a store down the street, and together they opened what would be the first Whole Foods market. As part of the agreement with the owners, Mackey agreed to start selling a wider assortment of products. They started selling meat and sugar, as well as beer and wine. Mackey agreed to this because many of his customers had asked him to start selling a wider assortment of items so they could do all their grocery shopping at his store instead of only buying some items and having to visit another store for the rest. The store was honestly a fabulous success right from the start, becoming profitable by 3 p.m. the first day, according to Mackey. Things were looking up for the first 9 months until Texas experienced a once-in-a-century storm that flooded the store. See, when Mackey was picking a location for the first store, in order to get better rent, he picked a location that was located on a 100-year flood. Plane, not knowing that 9 months after opening, Texas was going to experience a once-in-a-century flood. 6 inches of water came down in just a few hours, completely flooding his store. Mackey was devastated. He thought everything was lost. He thought he'd have to shut down and everyone would lose all their money. What he didn't expect was the overwhelming amount of community support that came after the flood. Vendors willingly gave free replacement product, employees worked for free, and community members came and helped clean up the mess. They opened 28 days after the flood, which is just incredible considering they had no insurance. This made Mackey realize they had to expand, and in 1989, the TV show 60 Minutes gave them some help. 60 Minutes ran a segment on the apple growth regulator called Alar. This was a growth regulator used at the time by many farmers, and 60 Minutes showed some terrible footage of this stuff being sprayed all over the apple. Honestly, it's pretty gross. And after this segment ran, the news had multiple segments of how consumers were saying they were only going to buy organic and no longer trusted conventional produce. This was great for Whole Foods as a company, as at the time, they were one of the only places where you could get a wide range of organic produce. Fueled by this and some venture capitalist funds, they started to experience incredible growth. In order to fuel this growth, Mackey was going to have to give up control of the company to the venture capitalists, and he did not want to do that, because as he said, venture capitalists are like hitchhikers. If you take them where they want to go, they'll pay for the gas. But if you don't take them where they want to go, they'll try to hijack the car, kick you out, and hire a new driver. Mackey didn't want this to happen to him, so he thought it would be best just to take the company public and get the hijackers out of the car. So Whole Foods went public on January 23rd, 1992. Over the 90s and early 2000s, Whole Foods used its stock to acquire multiple competitors, becoming the undisputed leader in its industry. Its growth was so fast, some even started comparing it to Google. And honestly, things were looking really good for the company. That is, until they ran into some controversies. They got in trouble for hiring some prison labor, and they also got in trouble for overcharging customers by overstating the amount of product that was actually in their packages. This, combined with the fact that many larger competitors started offering a pretty good organic assortment of their own, Whole Foods' business started to struggle. Their stock price started plummeting, and this is when Amazon came in and offered to buy it. Amazon offered to buy Whole Foods for $13.7 billion. Now, it's clear why this is good for Whole Foods, but why would Amazon want to do this? They're the online giant. Well, not only does this allow them to sell their products like the Echo and the Kindle in all the Whole Food locations, it also gives them access to a vast amount of data that they would not be able to get any other way. Through their Prime membership, Amazon will now be able to track shoppers' habits both on and offline, which is just incredibly valuable. And this is only the start. Amazon has a pilot project in Seattle where they have a store without cashiers. You just walk in, pick up what you want, and walk out, and it's billed to your Amazon account. If they can perfect this technology and implement it at all the Whole Foods, that could be revolutionary for the retail industry. Okay, that's it for today, guys. This is my first video, so I'd really love your feedback in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed it, please don't forget to subscribe and leave a like. Thanks.